This video was brought to you by the ILC. Hi there, welcome to episode 4, Writing Equations of Lines in Point-Slope Form. In this episode, we'll give you 2 points, and then we're going to have you create an equation of the line using Point-Slope Form. Let's get started. Now, in order to find the equation of a line in Point-Slope Form, first we have to start from the Point-Slope equation. And it goes like this. Y minus y1 equals m times the quantity x minus x1. We're going to need to plug in 3 values to that equation. We're going to need an x1 value, which I will underline in red. We are going to need a y1 value, which I will underline in green. And we will need an m value, or a slope, which I will underline in blue. Now, the first thing we're going to do is we are going to label the points that we were given, the 2, 6, and the 4, 5, with x1, y1, x2, and y2. The first point will be labeled with the x1 and y1. We will label the x-coordinate, that is the 2, in red. Call that x1, and we will label the y-coordinate in green, that's the 6. There is our x1 and y1. For the other point, we will do the same thing. We will label the x-coordinate as x2, and the y-coordinate as y2. So if you look back at this equation, the y1 and the x1 we already have. They are 2 and 6. Now all we need is to find the slope. And there's an equation we have to use to find the slope as well. We'll use m equals y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. And if you forgot to label your points, you'd have some difficulty with this equation keeping the variables straight. Well, let's plug in our variables into that equation. So m is equal to y2 minus y1, that is 5 minus 6, divided by x2 minus x1, that is 4 minus 2. Well, 5 minus 6 is negative 1, and 4 minus 2 is 2. So our slope is negative 1/2, and I will circle that in blue. So now we have all 3 of the pieces of our puzzle, the m, the x1, and the y1. So now let's rewrite the equation that we had previously. Y minus y1 equals m, x minus x1. Except for now, let us replace the y1 with the number that y1 is. The y1 was in green, so I will write it in green again. The y1 is 6. And the m is the number that was circled in blue, so I will continue using blue. That's negative 1/2. And the x1 is the number that's in red, so I will continue using red. And that's 2. The rest of the equation remains the same. So this y that I'm underlining and this x that I'm underlining, we don't change those. So our equation becomes y minus 6 equals 1/2 times the quantity x minus 2. And now we're almost there. Our final step is to try to simplify this equation a little bit, because most instructors like it if you simplify things as much as possible. Well, the first way we can simplify is multiply this negative 1/2 times this x and times this 2. So our equation will become this. The left side does not change. We still have y minus 6. The right side will now become negative 1/2 x, and then negative 1/2 times negative 2 gives us positive 2 over 2. But if you know your fractions, you realize that 2 over 2 is just 1. Now the only thing left to do is to combine like terms. So we can move the negative 6 that is on the left side over to the right. I'll write the simplifications in green here. Now since we have negative 6 here already, we have to do the opposite. We have to add 6 to both sides. So the negative 6 and the plus 6 cancel out, and our final equation is y equals negative 1/2 x, and then positive 1 plus 6 gives us plus 7. And this is our final answer. Now, this version of the equation is oftentimes referred to as slope-intercept form. Now, we are going to hear quite a bit more about this in the next learning objective. But for now, this problem is finished. Our answer is y equals negative 1/2 x plus 7. Thank you all for watching. We'll see you next episode.